Anybody here yet? We'll see if anyone shows up. In my never-ending quest for watchers. Says five. We'll see who has the guts to announce themselves to the world. Who does not have the shame? Anyway, this is Inktober 20, and the prompt is treasure. So I went back and forth on a couple different things. Thinking like, you know, national treasure as far as an actor goes, blah, blah, blah. But then today, it was still blank. It was the only one that was still blank. Hey, John. So, I just decided, even though I painted Indiana Jones a few times, I'd do it again, just a different pose. And as usual, they're FW inks. Pretty much ready to get started here. Oh, and for those few of you that were wondering if I was going to do a playmat of that Clockwork Orange piece, I did order some playmats of it. So just remind me, check back in a couple weeks. All right. So where do I start with this one? I think I'm going to start with the eyes. I'm going to leave the highlight white rather than try and paint it in later, since I mentioned the white in this ink doesn't always seem to be that opaque. So, while I listen to Marianne Faithfull and Mark Isham's Trouble in Mind soundtrack on my headphones, I will finish these eyeballs. Maybe I'll just leave this like this. I think this looks good. It's almost like a cartoon. Then after I'm done with this, gotta do two or three of these little vampire character portraits. Two of them that I have drawn already. So I got a fairly good start. Had to run some errands and stuff. I got the drawings done before I left. There's an awful lot of red in this particular, at least the reference shot that I'm using. Really dramatically lit by the reflections and stuff of this golden treasure head that he's puzzling over. So, I think probably the thing to do would be to put a layer of like a very light yellowish orange over all the flesh tone. And then I'll go in again with various darker shades and stuff. And I'll probably have to put a little bit of white in here and there. It's going to look very weird for a few minutes. This is wet. I'll see if you can pull out some lighter areas for some of these strongly lit bits here and there. Sometimes it soaks in and stains the paper a little bit too quick to be able to do that. Depending on, I think it just depends on how wet you left the area, if it's still wet enough to pull stuff out of. Hey, Tracy. Tracy, long time watcher, first time listener, or something like that. Yeah, I love doing that lifting out procedure. I've said many times it creates usually some very organic looking highlights. Okay, now I think I'll try and do some of the darker areas here, which will most likely get even darker. Say hello, people. I think this one's going to be somewhat fun just because of the saturated palette, because I tend to work that way anyway. Well, hey, six people. You guys can say something. Let me know who's here. And anyone that comes in who's wondering what is going on, this is Inktober 20, with the prompt being treasure, and hopefully, obviously, Indiana Jones, with his treasure that he wants so bad. There's no snakes here, John. There's only a big boulder waiting to fall on his head. Well, I think this palette's working out pretty good so far. Now for a few darker darks, a few spots. And when I was getting ready to start this, I was sort of reminded by how many movies, amazing big movies, some of them really, really good, that Harrison Ford has either been in or more usually been the star of. I mean, it's like really boggles the mind. I mean, you think about it. I mean, he was even in, like, Apocalypse Now. He had a small part in that. Along with some other movies. Well, American Graffiti and all that other real early stuff. Before the big Star Wars, Indiana Jones. Like, World Takeover. Okay, time to move on. Got that face pretty much done, I think. The silent crowd. Tiny crowd, but silent. Okay, I think I will move on to the hat. You guys really can talk. Honest, you can, really. to... Well, I think I'll do the jacket. Gotta get some... Get a piece of violet up in there. Oh, you guys are quiet. You should know that by now. On to the golden god. I'm on drugs. I'm a golden god. I'm on drugs. Along with art, you get obscure movie references. Okay, so what do I need here? I think I've got a couple shades of yellow, a couple shades of orange. Oh, orange is in sepias. First, lay in the big area of yellow here. Thank you. Oh, hey, Jenny. Someone actually spoke. Sorry, I was getting too used to nobody being here or saying anything. No, this is another Inktober thing. The prompt for this is treasure. Thanks. Yeah, I think it's turning out pretty good. It helped that I started out really saturated and not, didn't worry about building up slowly when it came to Indiana Jones himself. Okay, after I get this faint green mossy stuff done, I can go on and add a nice, fun, indistinct background. The cave will be indistinct, various shapes in the background. I'm going to probably try and hold to it to some degree, but it's not going to be there's not going to really be much detail because I want to focus on the foreground.
Excuse me.
One last sip of a beverage, and then I'll start on this background. Yeah, this Flaming Lips, this new Flaming Lips CD is really good. He said randomly. Okay. golden effect. You mean on this? These are yellows and sepias and oranges, if that's what you're asking about. And I'm going to dial back this green once I get these various sort of shapes done. I should probably stop. I think it's pretty much done. Oh, the eternal dilemma, where to sign? And when to stop? Yeah, I think I'm done with this. Oh, no I'm not. Every time I see something that needs to be done. Done and doneer. Now I'll take a little break and jump on these little vampire portraits. Thanks for watching, folks, and sharing and all that. See you later.